If you are watching this video, you've probably automated your full backups nightly. But what about the in-between time? If the database needed to be restored at this moment, you would be missing all the changes since your last backup. Yikes! Hi, I'm Carlos L Chacon, one of your friends at SQL Data Partners, and in this video, I'm going to walk you through the process of taking a log backup. Let's get started. In order to take a transaction log backup, two things have to be true about your database. First, the database has to be in what's called full recovery mode. This tells SQL Server you care about the changes that happen throughout the day. If you look at the database properties and then click on the Options tab, this recovery model must say full. Second, you must have taken a full backup in full recovery mode at some point prior to taking the transaction log backup. With a full backup, I'm going to get a snapshot of the data at that time. This is a starting copy of that data. Normally, this will happen at night or during off hours. The log backup will save the changes you made during the day, giving me a new recovery point with each one. Log backups can occur as frequently as every 15 minutes, but you can decide how often you need to take them based on how much your data changes and what data loss might look like for you. If you're not sure, start with hourly. This database is in full recovery mode, and I have taken a full backup. Now let's take a log backup. I can right-click on the database I want to back up, I go into Tasks, and I'm going to choose Backup. I specify Transaction Log for the backup type, enter the location of where I want the log backup to be saved, and click OK to take the backup. I can repeat the automation pieces with maintenance plans and automate the log backups. I'll go into the maintenance plan, name the plan to include log backups, and choose a log backup frequency of daily, repeated every hour. I want to choose the transaction log option for the task I want to run. I will include all databases and specify a destination. You should not need to make any changes on the Options tab. I'll accept the defaults for the log and notification, and I'm all set. When I click Finish, the job will be created and my log backups will start happening. In this video, I've showed you how to take a log backup. Check out our channel for tips, trainings, and our podcast episodes. Insert yourself into our community by clicking the subscribe button. Select the thumbs up if you like the video, hit the bell for updates, and join the conversation with a comment below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the SQL Trail.
SQL Data Partners.